Hey everybody, my name is Tom Brown, and I'm a trumpet player with the Eastern Connecticut Symphony Orchestra here in New London, Connecticut. And thanks for tuning in. I'm excited to do this video for you to tell you a little bit about myself and my history, how I came to play the trumpet, and why I still play it, and also to play some music for you. I started playing the trumpet in the sixth grade. I was 12 years old, and I was really entranced by music because I had been listening to music since before I could even remember. And also, the trumpet could play really loud, so that was really exciting as well. And I knew that trumpet could play all sorts of music. You could play in a jazz band, you could play in an orchestra, a concert band, you could play in a church, you could play in a parade, you could do anything with a trumpet. And so my parents got me a cornet, which is what we started on in the sixth grade, and brought it home. And my parents told me I couldn't open it up and start playing until we had our first band lesson, so I wouldn't get any bad habits. But I did it anyways. I was so excited. I buzzing on the mouthpiece and playing the cornet. I didn't even know what I was doing, but I knew I was so excited. So I practiced every single day, really, from then on. My parents would help me out. We would talk through some things, and I would practice every night, usually in the basement. It wasn't the most fun place to practice, but I didn't really care. I just wanted to learn everything there was to know about the trumpet. And eventually that took me through high school, and I knew I wanted to be a professional musician in high school. I knew I wanted to go into it. I knew that was for me. I didn't know exactly how. I didn't know if I was going to be a band director or a performer or what was going to happen. But I knew I had to be involved with trumpet and music. So I went to college for 6 years, and I did everything you're supposed to do in college, and I took all these auditions and stuff, and I landed an audition here in New London, Connecticut, which is where I currently play, with the U.S. Coast Guard Band and also with the Eastern Connecticut Symphony Orchestra. And currently, I mean, I still play. I practice about 3 hours a day playing, I don't know, six or seven different trumpets that I have in order to do the different jobs that I have. And I still love it just as much as when I was in the sixth grade, 12 years old. It's still so much fun and sends a shiver up my spine. Every time we play with the orchestra and we get to play a trumpet solo that soars out over the orchestra, there's no better feeling in the world than that. So anyways, I wanted to play some tunes for you too while we're here. The first tune that you heard was a trumpet concerto written by Alexander Aratunian. Now, a concerto is when a musician gets to play in front of the orchestra, which almost never happens for trumpet players. So that's one of our favorite things to do. And on this particular piece, he's standing out in front of the orchestra, and it's this really loud, boisterous singing piece, which is tons of fun to play. And that was the opening segment to the Aratunian trumpet concerto. Next piece I'd like to play for you is a very somber piece written by Gustav Mahler. His most famous symphony is the Fifth Symphony, and the trumpet gets to start the whole thing. Talk about nerve-wracking. You've got about 90 musicians sitting around you, and the conductor comes on stage and gives a tuning note, and everybody sits down, and the audience is dead silent, waiting for what's going to happen, and the trumpet has to start off like this. Sometimes orchestras get so fed up with the trumpet players, they kick them off the stage, like in this next piece I'd like to play for you by Beethoven. This is the overture to Leonore No. 3, an opera he wrote. And in one part, he wrote for the trumpet to be off stage, playing a call to battle. It goes something like this. Thank you. Now, most of the time, trumpet parts are written to be loud and boisterous and soaring over the orchestra and pretty aggressive. That's generally what we play most of the time, which is tons of fun, believe me. But one thing we like to do more than almost anything else is to play beautifully and lyrically, like we're singing. This next piece is from Respighi's Pines of Rome. Once again, the trumpet is offstage, playing a beautiful singing lyrical solo that the audience can barely hear off in the distance. It sounds like this. Igor Stravinsky's Song of a Nightingale is one of the most beautiful, haunting melodies the trumpet gets to play in all of orchestral literature. Stravinsky asks the player to play pianissimo, which means extra soft, and the audience has to strain to hear this beautiful solo from the trumpet. Johann Sebastian Bach wrote for trumpet, but he didn't make it easy for us. He wrote extremely high on the trumpet. So we use this instrument called a piccolo trumpet, which allows us to play very high. And one of the great pieces he wrote was called Magnificat, and the trumpet plays the opening of this in a very joyful manner. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching this video. I had a blast making it. I hope you guys really enjoy watching it. And next time you get a chance, come check out the Eastern Connecticut Symphony. We play a lot of great music. As a trumpet player, I also love playing jazz. It's one of my favorite things to do. I've got my own jazz band. I play in several different jazz bands. And this next song is one of my favorite songs I like to do. It's called When the Saints Go Marching In. Thanks a lot and have a great day.